Hey guys, hope you're having a great day as well as a great life out here in the Freedom Shack.
Pause a little bit on that, but that's all right. It's cool. We just adding some commas.
Emphasis.
So Molly Hatchet, Dreams I'll Never See. I gotta be honest, not super excited about the song title.
Why, dude?
It just feels corny a little
really?
Bit. Really? Dreams I'll Never See.
But I put it, you can only see, it's. I kind of have to agree with you, but I'm gonna give you a rebuttal because you know just why not? But let's say so. I feel like part of it is because you haven't heard the song yet. Because it's like you think, like, let's say, like, Aerosmith, Dream On,
yeah.
right? So if you haven't heard the song yet, I was like, Dream On, like, okay, rock band with a song called Dream On. But when you hear it, like, you never talk shit on that song ever because it's
yeah.
amazing.
No, it's fact.
So we'll see how they – it just depends how they own it.
If they own it – I've been surprised by – I mean, I think literally recently with what was the one song with the – I'm Sexy or whatever.
Oh, yeah. Dahlia, I Think I'm Sexy.
Yeah. Yeah, so that one, I'm like, we were so ready to hate it, and then great song. So there's a world in which I'm wrong, and I really hope that's this world.
Yeah, I mean, we freaking loved 41 Disaster.
It's true.
Like, that was just, like, a standard drive around town up to no good banger.
Yeah, so hopefully that's the same thing.
I don't think it'll be the same thing, but I think it'll be a different
same magnitude, flavor. Different flavor. Yeah.
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 So either way, make sure to like the video and all that good jazz, and let's jump into it.
Let's do it. Okay, all right. Already cool. Interesting.
I like the
yeah. All right. Yeah, cool drums. Just one more morning. I have to wake up with the blues. Pull myself out of bed, yeah. Put on my walking shoes. Climb up on a hilltop, baby.
Good bass.
Mm-hmm.
The end on that last bop.
Yeah, I thought there was going to be more.
Rule number six, broken.
Okay. Were you in a soft?
Shattered. No.
Yeah, okay, so then I don't think they broke any rules.
I mean, initially, it felt like there were so many different things that I liked, but it was just, like, so much random shit in one bucket.
Yeah, I agree.
You know what I mean? But there's a lot of, like, cool independent things. You know what I mean?
Dude, I got to be honest. I'm going to get this rating out right away.
Really?
I think it's like a C-minus song to me.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Continue.
I was excited by the beginning so hard. When it started, I was so excited with the way he was playing guitar. I was like, that's a really atmospheric, cool intro. Everything kind of built, like, with the organ and all that sounded so cool. That's kind of my only thing that I liked about the song.
Like, how it started. Like, the first 43 seconds.
Yeah, but, like, overall, I didn't think the chorus was that strong. It kind of just felt like a slight change in melody from the verse.
I really liked the chorus, minus, like, the weird stops. I actually even liked it, when the stops would occur, like, you know how it would do, like, two runs of that part?
Yeah.
I liked the second half of it, because he would kind of, like, scream, like, in sync with it. It was like, kind of cool. But, like, the first one I don't like.
What I liked about the stops was the tone of the stops I thought was really cool. Whatever, like, effects they used all together sounded really, really sonically cool there. But I thought it was, like, just them trying too hard. Like, they were like, oh, it'd be cool if this was out of time. Let's, like, make people not be able to bob their heads to it. Was kind of how it felt.
Yeah, I could definitely see that. I think, like, the main part of the chorus before that, that feels like the post-chorus. But before that, like, that chorus, I think the reason I like it isn't that it's, like, a great chorus or anything, but I think it's because I just like the percussionist. Like, the drummer, he's very, like, just in general. And we said this, like, when we did Fortnite Disaster, he's very kind of like Neil Peart a little bit in how he plays. So I think I'm kind of just, like, following his groove, and I'm almost, like, imagining it from the perspective of the drummer, and it feels, like, saucy when it's happening. But that doesn't mean that the whole thing is actually saucy.
To me, it felt very much like somebody imitating Rush. Not that they did imitate Rush. I don't know what year this came out in respective to, like, Rush songs. It just felt like... like, somebody was trying to play Yes or Rush but didn't understand why it was cool. Like, when they play something weird and polyrhythmic and out of time, it's like, it's not just because it's out of time that it makes it cool. So, I don't know. I just didn't love that. I thought his vocals on this were just, like, so guttural, like, sound like marbles in his mouth. Not to hate on him.
Like, really, I liked his vocals.
I thought he sang it okay. It was just, like, whatever tone that he had on Flirting with Disaster, I thought it fit really well in that context. But in this context, I just didn't love it.
Really?
So, I don't know. It just... there was nothing that stuck out to me that was, like, super awesome. And then even the bridge section, to me, felt like a B-side. Like, it felt like a B-side song, which that's fair. Like, there are some songs that needs to happen. And the only saving feature for it for me was, like, this guitar
tambourine.
Solo.
Oh.
And the tambourine. Tambourine and the guitar solo. But it's also, like, you're coming to Molly Hatchet. Like, we already heard what they could do on Flirting with Disaster. Like, the guitar is going to be great no matter what. But, so, yeah. Anyways, that was my
thoughts. Guitar is definitely cool. It developed nice because it started off, like, super, like, melodic. And for a second, I thought that's all it was going to be, just kind of like this, like, melodic, like, play on, you know, the chords and stuff. But then it got pretty dirty. Not too dirty, but it got PG-13.
It got PG-13. This is definitely something you could see without your parents, but your parents still might not be okay with you seeing it had they known. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So the guitar solo I thought was great.
I think it's a B song.
Yeah.
I don't think I'll listen to it often, but I think all things considered in terms of this, like, weird southern-ish Rush rock, pretend Rush rock like region.
Yeah.
I think they've kind of got it on lock. I just really don't like how the time, like, the one big thing holding it back from me is just, like, those, like, drop clashes, like, being, like, so, because it is, like, what you said, like, it feels, like, forced. And, like, when Rush does it, or, you know, like, Yes, it never feels forced.
Yeah.
It always feels like, well, of course they're going to play it like that. This feels like, okay, you're trying to, like, prove a point a little bit. But overall, I think all things considered, it's a B song. I do think Flirting with Disaster is way better.
Significantly.
But, yeah, so that's, like, that's the A&A take.
Yeah, I didn't mean to hate on it. I still like Molly Hatchet. I thought Flirting with Disaster was great, and I'm excited to hear other stuff they do. This just, to me, didn't tickle my fancy.
So the title did not hold up?
No.
Not like Aerosmith.
No, it did not. No, but I also didn't think it was going to be as cool. Like, in my head, the title sounded cornier than the song was. It wasn't corny. It just felt like it fell flat to me.
Yeah.
Like, there's nothing they did horrible. There was just nothing that I, like, loved.
This is fair.
So, but either way, excited to hear more. Like, even though it doesn't sound like I am.
All right. Well, with that said, thanks for stopping by the Freedom Shack to get, you know, two punk college students' opinion on your music.
Yeah, also, PSA at the end of this. I know nothing. So anyways, with that being said, we'll catch you next video.
Peace.